Hey guys, Joe here. One of the most amazing things in nature is the... Is that safe? Sorry, one of our lights is... It's okay, where was I? One of the most amazing things in nature is that... Crap. That was definitely one of my two favorite arms. Now I've just got one left. And if there's one rule about losing an arm, it's that they don't grow back. Unless you're this guy. I don't mean Deadpool. Well, I do, but I really mean this guy, the axolotl. You guys remember Amber, our friend from the Tuatara video?
Hi.
Amber helps take care of the axolotls here at the Dallas Zoo. Axolotls are salamanders, a type of amphibian.
They kind of look like they're smiling too. Like, this is really cute.
They have
happy little dopey faces.
Like other amphibians, salamanders spend their first days in the water, breathing with gills and swimming with tails. Most amphibians lose these traits when they become adults, when they leave the water and start breathing with lungs or through their skin. But axolotls spend their whole lives in the water, so they never lose juvenile traits like those big gills. Prepare to have your mind blown and then regenerated, because axolotls can do that.
But by far the coolest thing is the fact that they have the ability to regenerate lost limbs.
In the 1700s, an Italian priest started cutting body parts off of animals. Kind of a weird hobby. He noticed that starfish, flatworms, these could all regrow their arms and bodies. Cool, but they're pretty simple creatures. No bones or anything like that. When he sliced off a salamander's arm, though, he saw something shocking. It regrew the entire arm. Bones, muscles, and nerves, and blood vessels, and everything. Deadpool style.
So cut off arms, legs, eyes, mouth, tail, anything, and they regrow it.
Yeah.
Like normal.
Yeah, perfect copies.
That is wild.
The juvies and babies are super cannibalistic, and so they're eating each other's limbs, toes, and the ability to regrow them would be very helpful.
What's even stranger is an axolotl can even regenerate half its own heart or part of its brain. That is crazy. In what is now Mexico, axolotls were known to the Aztecs for centuries. Aztecs even occasionally ate them.
So they're native to an underground lake. The name's a little interesting.
I looked up the name. We're not even gonna try to pronounce it.
No, it's Xochimilco.
We're gonna put the name like...
Xochimilco.
Xochimilco?
Xochimilco.
We'll also put it like right here.
Yeah.
So we can... Xochimilco.
Xochimilco.
Because of the growth of Mexico City, you'll probably never see an axolotl outside of a glass tank today. They're almost extinct in the wild. But biologists are studying the animals in captivity to see if their powers of regeneration might one day help humans regrow lost body parts. If I cut off my arm for real, it won't grow back, and I might bleed to death, or I might get a bad infection. But an axolotl can regenerate without these problems. We don't have a complete understanding of how it happens, but here's basically what goes down. Right after an amputation, a signal is sent to cells all over an axolotl's body, telling them to start dividing. Next, skin cells create a living band-aid over the wound. Now, this is really important for everything that comes next. The animal can't regenerate without it. After about a week, this bump, called a blastema, pops up, and everything that will become the new limb grows from that little nub. New cartilage starts to form, notches show up where the digits, fingers, or toes will go, and 6 to 10 weeks later, the salamander has a complete limb where there was once a stump. Take a second and think about how cool that is. We're talking blood vessels, nerves, muscles, everything reconnected seamlessly.
You are a magical creature. So obviously, yeah, like people lose their limbs, it would be cool if we could regenerate them Deadpool style, but we can't do that.
We can't do that.
So if, by studying these and how they do it, maybe we can stimulate that in humans.
Yeah, maybe we can eventually learn to do that.
That would be awesome.
Scientists think this is within reach. Now, don't try this at home, but there have been cases where young children regrew a fingertip after an injury. And some of our organs, like our skin, already regenerate constantly. The secrets to axolotl-like healing might already be hidden in our own bodies. We just have to find them. Think about it. Before you were born, you grew a little bud that formed a paddle, which eventually became an arm. The instructions to do all that are still in your DNA when you're an adult. We just have to figure out how to turn those growth switches back on. Of course, it's not easy. There's no gene that says arm, finger, or hand, and you won't find literal blueprints for growing a limb in your DNA. It's one of the most incredibly complex processes evolution has ever crafted. There's dozens of genes involved in building a limb, and they don't work like instructions for, say, building furniture. The genes work more like sheet music for an orchestra. Different instruments play different notes at different times, sometimes together, sometimes on their own. It's the timing and where things are played that creates the symphony, not just the sheet music itself. Growing a limb works in a similar way. Dozens of genes interacting with others, each playing tiny parts in a special order, creates the whole. The secret to remaking an arm or a leg seems to be turning back the genetic clock to the very youngest days of an animal's development. Pausing the adult arm programming and growing the limb like it was the first time. Because the axolotls are forever young, they may have a leg up. Even if we never get to the point of regrowing complete limbs, the lessons we learned studying axolotls could help us regrow specific tissues like muscle, which is pretty awesome on its own. I'd like to give you a hand.
I want to say a huge thank you to my new friend, the axolotl, and to Amber for all of the awesome axolotl facts.
Yeah, man, you sure do axolotl questions.
Thanks a lot all for answering them.
Of course.
All right, stay curious. Am I on key? Am I good?
And action.
Forever young.